everybody doing out there? This is Pastor Britt Strohecker, and welcome to episode 120 of Closer to God. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we love you and adore you, and we thank you for all that you're doing for us. Help us to get closer to you this day by, again, turning to your word, studying it, and listening for your still small voice to speak to us through it so that we can not only draw closer to you, but learn more about you and learn more about how we are to approach life and apply these teachings to our lives. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, today we're going to finish up Chapter 14 of Acts. We're going to be looking at verses 21 through 28, and this is where Paul and Barnabas return to Antioch of Syria. And it starts here at verse 21 saying, "After preaching the good news in Derbe and making many disciples, Paul and Barnabas returned again to Lystra, Iconium, and Antioch of Pisidia, where they strengthened the believers. They encouraged them to continue in the faith, reminding them that they must enter into the kingdom of God through many tribulations." And let's stop right there, because they're speaking from experience here. If you remember from episode 119, we were looking at verses 19 and 20 in that particular portion of this chapter 14 of Acts. It says here, "Now some Jews arrived from Antioch and Iconium and turned the crowds into a murderous mob." So what was happening? Remember, Paul and Barnabas were preaching the good news of the gospel, and they performed many miracles, and that stirred up some of the people in the crowd who believed in Greek gods. And they claimed that Paul was one of the Greek gods and that Barnabas must be the other guy. And they went as far as dragging some of the priests from the Greek temple to where Paul and Barnabas were, and they were going to offer sacrifices to them and worship them as gods. And Paul and Barnabas were like, whoa, you guys got this all wrong. We're the Lord's messengers. We are not gods. We are here to bring you the good news of the gospel. And now, with that situation going on, remember, they were not well accepted in some of the other towns, and some of those folks who were their critics, who slandered them and tried to discredit them, followed them to where they were, and they stirred up the crowd and turned the crowd against Paul and Barnabas, and they turned them into what the Bible calls here a murderous mob. They stoned Paul and dragged him out of the city, apparently dead. So they stoned Paul to the point where he was just out cold and was looking lifeless to them. You know, so talk about tribulation, okay? "But as the believers stood around him, he got up and went back into the city. The next day he left with Barnabas for Derbe." And that's where we're picking it up today. So when they say that, when they're encouraging the believers to continue in the faith, reminding them that they must enter into the kingdom of God through many tribulations, they're not kidding. And we have to understand that sometimes there's a cost in following Christ. And not everybody's going to be very receptive or positive towards the message of the good news that we take out into the world. And especially in today's world, with the way things have changed to the current state of affairs in the world around us, we may be facing some more persecution than what we're accustomed to or maybe even comfortable with. But it's nothing new, because this is nothing in comparison to the scale of persecution that the early church experienced during this time. So, you know, they're encouraging people to continue in the faith and reminding them that it's not going to be a bed of roses. And just because you're a follower of Christ, you're not going to be walking down the primrose path every day of life. There are going to be challenges and struggles, and they're encouraging them, look, we have what the strength we need through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to face these challenges and these tribulations head on, okay? So at verse 23, it says, "Paul and Barnabas also appointed elders in every church and prayed for them with fasting, turning them over to the care of the Lord in whom they had come to trust." And this is very important here. Look what they're doing here. They're looking for the church leaders in every church, and they are praying and fasting for them, turning them over to the care of the Lord. In other words, entrusting them to God, in whom they themselves trusted. And we need to continue to do this today. We need to give our ministries to God so that He can indeed guide and direct us and lead us on the right path so that we are not straying away or putting our own spin on the Bible. And let me warn you, there are churches out there that are doing just that. I'm just checking my collar. Sometimes I record these and my collar is all a mess. I don't know if you guys ever noticed that, but I don't know. I just got a glimpse of it while I'm talking to you here, and I just was going to check on that. But, you know, very serious point here. There are churches out there who are spinning the Word of God to meet today's standards. In other words, they're changing the Word of God to conform to worldly standards. And remember, what does God tell us in Romans chapter 12? Let's turn back there. Romans chapter 12, verse 2, it says, don't copy the behavior and customs of this world. Did you hear that? Don't copy the behavior and the customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Then you will know what God wants you to do, and you will know how good and pleasing and perfect His will really is. So, instead of having God and His holy word transform and conform to worldly ideologies, we are not to copy the behaviors and customs of this world, but we are to have God and His holy word transform us. So if you find yourself in a situation where it's obvious that a church is conforming the word of God or conforming what's acceptable and what's not acceptable according to worldly standards instead of godly standards that are listed in God's word, that's a church you need to get away from. And I mean that. I'm as serious as a heart attack on that, okay? And you know, this just goes along to show that, look, like I said, and like Paul and Barnabas are saying here, look, don't expect following Jesus to be a primrose path where you have no worries, no struggles, no problems or issues to overcome in your daily walk of life. You know, there you're just being unrealistic. But realistically, you can face all those things with Jesus and His word by your side, okay? So when we go about the business of ministering for the Lord, we need to turn it over to Him and allow Him to lead instead of us trying to take the lead and trying to make people feel good kind of condone and champion the things that are going on in the world that the world says, hey, you need to accept this, or this is now acceptable. This is now changed. The standards have now changed. You know, the world can change their standards many, many times over, and they're going to constantly change. But one thing that doesn't change is the holy word of God. And that's where we need to place our trust. And that's exactly what Paul and Barnabas are displaying to the early church by fasting and praying for the leadership and turning them over to the Lord in whom they trusted. So let's look at verse 24 here. Then they traveled back through Pisidia to Pamphylia. They preached again in Perga and then went to Attalia. Finally, they returned by ship to Antioch of Syria, where their journey had begun and where they had been committed to the grace of God for the work they had now completed. Upon arriving in Antioch, they called the church together and reported about their trip, telling all that God had done and how He had opened the door of faith to the Gentiles too. And they stayed there with the believers in Antioch for a long time. So here we have Paul and Barnabas. They went out on their first missionary journey, and it had its successes, and it also had its very difficult periods, even a lot of bodily harm and injury when people tried to stone Paul to death, as we read about. So they gave this report to the believers, and this is how we encourage one another in the church. We give our testimony on how the Lord guided us, directed us through good times, through bad times, and through ugly times. That's what they were doing, and that's what we need to do in today's world too. You know, we don't need just to discuss the Bible and the things that God has done in the past. We can utilize His word and see how He's still working in the today and now in our lives, and we need to provide that testimony to one another to encourage one another. So until next time, remember, nothing in this world is more important than the love of Jesus Christ. I'll talk to you soon.